Do you have DNA surprises in your family tree? My guess is that you do. Hi, I'm Aimee. Join me today on this rainy day in California for a surprise that Julia Roberts got when she found out that maybe she isn't really a Roberts. So Julia Roberts, I love her. She's a great actress and I really do enjoy her movies. And she was recently on Ancestry's Find Your Roots with Henry Louis Gates Jr. It was a great episode. The whole episode starts off with her saying, "Is my head on straight still? Am I facing you?" Let me say, she was really surprised at some discoveries that the Ancestry crew made as they were researching her family tree. So today I'm going to talk to you a little bit more about what happened to Julia, give you some more documents and information than you saw, at least in the episode on the YouTube show. Also, tell you a little bit more about how you can have DNA surprises like this in your family tree and kind of how to discover them and warn you a little bit about some of the things that you might find. Anyway, give you a little bit of DNA information. So what are some of the DNA surprises you might have in your family tree? You might find out that you have a parent that is different than you thought. Your dad may not be your dad. I've had that happen to clients. And you might find out that you have a sibling that you didn't know, either a full or half sibling. You might find out that you have surprise grandparents or great-grandparents, and that's more often the case. And sometimes you're using DNA because you want to find out a mystery in your family tree. You know that you don't know the parents, or that something's wrong with the information about the parents, but you don't know who they are. And that was the case for Julia. So this is really interesting. So what happened? As most people know, Julia was born in 1967 in Georgia. And that's a location where her family has resided for quite some time. So let me tell you about her family. All right, in Julia's family tree, the big mystery happened with her paternal great-grandfather. John Pendleton Roberts, born in 1878, is Julia's great-grandfather. So we know that John Pendleton Roberts, born in 1878, to Rhoda Suttles, and Julia interjected here, Suttle is not anything anyone has called anyone in my family, by the way, which I thought that was pretty funny. Anyway, so, but reportedly, John took on the name of her husband, Willis Roberts. However, there was a big mystery here. You see, Willis died in 1864, and John wasn't born until 1878. So that's kind of impossible to have your father die 14 years before your birth. So obviously, he's probably not the father. Now, who could be the father? We know in the family tree, these are five children that were identified in census records. And the oldest two are likely Willis's kids, but the next three were all born after his death. Well, did he really die? What really happened? That information wasn't provided on the show. Let me show you some interesting stuff. So here's the 1880 census where Rhoda is listed with four of her children. The oldest daughter, I think, had already been married at this point and was no longer living with the family. And we see that John, Julia's great-grandfather, was only 2 years old at the time of the census. So the really cool paperwork was in military paperwork. So Rhoda applied for a widow's pension. So if we pull up that paper and make it a little bigger for you so that you can see it, you see Rhoda Roberts filed for a military widow's pension. Her husband was Willis R. Roberts, that he, quote, lost his life in March of 1864. And then it stated that he died of pneumonia at Camp Beulah near Savannah. We have a record that has illustrated that he truly had passed away before his son was ever born. So as a genealogist, you're like, hey, something's fishy here. Who's the daddy? Now, in most cases with records, you're not going to have any clue. Sometimes there were bastardy papers that were filed because the woman needed assistance, or sometimes there might be church records or court records, but a lot of times you're never going to have any clue as to who the father would be until the entrance of DNA. The actual DNA information and what DNA matched whom wasn't shown for privacy purposes on the Ancestry show. The one thing that we did know is that through cousin matches, they identified the father. The father was Henry McDonald Mitchell Jr. So Julia's a Mitchell, not actually a Roberts. So the process of identifying the matches is pretty detailed, and I'm not going to go into that right now. I do have some other videos, and I'll show a playlist later that will illustrate how you might be able to identify somebody in your matches. But essentially, they use shared matches to confirm that he was the father. So what they did was they found somebody that was known to be directly descended from him, and those people matched Julia's DNA in the appropriate place. The amount of DNA that is matched kind of indicates a relationship. So when you have a lot of DNA that's matching, then you know that that's a parent. When you have a smaller amount of DNA, then you know that's further up your family tree. And there's charts out there that tell you that DNA within this range would most likely be a first cousin or an aunt or something like that. So let's look at Henry McDonald Mitchell Jr. Here we find him in 1880. This is the same census that we found her great-grandfather, John. And so here you see him with his wife and six kids. And some of these kids are about the same age as John. Ancestry also said Henry's mother resided right near Rhoda Roberts. There's Rhoda, and there's Henry's reported mother. Maybe he was saying, I'm gonna go over and visit mom. So, lessons learned, Julia Mitchell? She said she prefers Roberts, and I don't blame her. But these things happen in our family trees. So, how do you find out if you have some DNA mysteries in your family tree? But I gotta warn you, if you do a DNA test, be prepared for surprises, because they're there. I know very few people that haven't done a DNA test and don't find some kind of surprise somewhere in their family tree. So you gotta be ready for it. My philosophy about it is we're real. We're people, and people did things and made mistakes sometimes, or we have no idea what circumstances that they were in, and I'm not judging. I just want to find out the information, at least as much as I can find out right now. So be ready for some of those surprises. Start looking into your family tree with records and find those mysteries. Like, they identified that there was an issue with this parent long before they did the DNA test. And so you can probably find similar things in your family tree. You're looking for inconsistencies. If a father has died so many years before a son was born, then you know he can't be the father. It's got to be somebody else. And finally, determine which DNA test will help you the most. I do have a video that talks about different DNA tests. I'm going to do a DNA playlist, like I said, at the end of the video. I also have a video about what does your ancestry DNA test tell you, and kind of go over the different results that you get when you do take a DNA test. And I'll put a link to that at the end of the show. So there's three main DNA tests that you can take for genealogical purposes like this. The first is autosomal DNA. Most people don't really hear that. They just hear a DNA test. If you take a test at Ancestry, you took an autosomal DNA test, and it's going to have matches from both sides of your family. And it's only good, though, for so many generations. The further out you go in your family tree, the more diluted your DNA. And then this test is not quite as accurate. It's great for great-grandparents, second great-grandparents, but when you get a lot beyond that, then it starts to lose its efficiency and effectiveness of it. A Y-DNA test will test the male line of your family tree, the male line only. A female can't do it. With women, we don't have Y-DNA. So you have to have a man from that line, and it will tell you the man up your tree. mtDNA will test females in your tree, and that is a little bit more complicated of a diagram to show you. So check out that video for more information on looking at an mtDNA test. The other really cool thing is that DNA advances are really happening quickly now. Ancestry just released the ability to divide your DNA matches into parent one and parent two. So if you did like a DNA test with one of your parents, then you can kind of know which DNA matches are on your mom's side of the family and which DNA matches are on your father's side of the family. Now, you were really able to do that before this advance. Now they've just made it very visible to you. So if you don't have as much experience understanding DNA, this is going to be really helpful to you. If you're a beginner, that's going to be really helpful for you. And more people are taking DNA tests, which results in more matches and therefore more success. So look for the mysteries in your family tree, and you might find something crazy like Julia Roberts did. And I don't know, I think finding these mysteries is really fun. So thanks for the program, Ancestry, and thanks for promoting genealogy and helping us find our families, because I gotta tell you, those mysteries are really fun. All right, some videos are popping up right now for you that may be of help for you if you want to do some additional research. If this video has been interesting to you, please give it a like and throw something in the comments if you have any crazy DNA mysteries in your family or any kinds of mysteries in your family. And if I can help you out in the comments, I'm happy to as well. So have a great day. Thanks.